The learning objective of this chapter is to examine the various parts of the supplement to the IMDG code, including emergency response procedures, the medical first aid guide, reporting procedures, packing cargo transport units, the safe use of pesticides in ships, the carriage of nuclear materials.
Appendix.
In many cases, an incident involving leakage from packaged dangerous goods on voyage will simply be contained by the ship's crew and left for specialist contractors to handle further. However, even that preliminary approach can be dangerous, and certainly, if a fire breaks out, fast and effective action by the ship's personnel will be required. The initial response to any emergency will be in accordance with the shipboard emergency plan. The emergency response procedures for ships carrying dangerous goods, called the EMS guide, are contained in the supplement to the IMDG code and are used in support of the shipboard plan. The emergency procedures are developed for a shipboard response where the master and crew have to react to and counter a fire or spillage without external assistance. In order to develop familiarity with its contents, the EMS guide will also be used in emergency drills and other training on board. All crew members should be thoroughly familiar with the introduction section of the guide. During the planning stage of a loading operation, those responsible should note the emergency schedules for the dangerous goods to be loaded. In the event of an emergency, the emergency schedules should dictate the type of response, followed by the crew. The EMS guide delivers guidance on dealing with fires and spillages of these substances on board ships. It contains the following sections. Click on the sections for more information. The International Medical Guide for Ships, published by the World Health Organization, is a general guide for medical treatment at sea. The Medical First Aid Guide for use in accidents involving dangerous goods, generally referred to as the MFAG, is a supplement to this guide and is jointly published by the International Maritime Organization, the World Health Organization, and the International Labour Organization. The MFAG is written around the substances, materials and articles covered by the IMDG code and the materials covered by Appendix B of the Code of Safe Practice for Solid Bulk Cargoes, the BC code. It is intended to provide advice necessary for the initial management of chemical poisoning and diagnosis within the limits of the facilities available at sea. The guide is divided into sections, which are structured to permit a rapid and easy three-step approach to secure the required medical advice. Click on the steps for more information. The reporting of incidents involving harmful substances and marine pollutants is regulated under MARPOL 7378. Recognizing that incidents at sea may give rise to the accidental discharge of substances which cause pollution or presents a threat of pollution, MARPOL identifies the need for any such incidents to be reported without delay in order to mobilize the necessary coastal state response. If you find a spill on board, you must report it to the responsible officer immediately. The master will report it on to the appropriate authorities. This section contains international guidelines for the packing of cargo transport units. Improper or careless packing of freight containers, swap bodies, vehicles, and other cargo transport units can lead to personal injury and material damage. If such units are improperly packed, it can result in an incident on board, and the crew may have to deal with it. The guidelines are intended to provide advice on safe packing of such units and a basis for training on such operations. Existing regulations and recommendations, such as contained in the company operations procedures, shall always be complied with, and this section is only to be read in support of such directives. Where dangerous goods form only part of the contents of a cargo transport unit, the dangerous cargo consignments should, wherever possible, be packed adjacent to the doors, in a secure manner, with markings and labels visible. This will permit easy access in the event of a problem. The recommendations in this section are intended as general guidance for use by competent authorities, mariners, fumigators, and fumigant and pesticide manufacturers. The control and eradication of insects and rodents is essential to prevent the spread of infection and disease. The International Code for the Safe Carriage of Packaged Irradiated Nuclear Fuel, Plutonium and High-Level Radioactive Wastes on Board Ships, or INF Code, is mandatory under SOLAS 1974, and is reproduced in the supplement. By definition, it relates to the carriage of various forms of radioactive material and waste. Vessels carrying such materials are bound by the requirements of both this code and the IMDG code. The appendix to the supplement contains the various legal resolutions and circulars referred to in the IMDG code and its supplement. Annex 2 of MARPOL 7378 also includes requirements for the prevention of pollution from dangerous goods which are transported as packages, in containers, in transportable tanks, or in road tankers. Where applicable, these should be read in conjunction with the provisions of the IMDG code.